Welcome to Common Heart. We're so glad that you're here for worship today. What a gift it is to be in blessed and beloved community together and invite others to this community as well. Let us give thanks for that today as we worship God together.
Turn, turn will be our delight till our
Today we look to the first chapter of Mark's Gospel. Jesus is out and on the move, teaching and preaching and sharing of the faith, and showing people who God is and what God is all about. Specifically today, we are going to pick up from Mark 1, verses 21 through 28. Hear now this word. They went to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, he entered the synagogue and taught. They were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. Just then there was in the synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." But Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Be silent and come out of him." And the unclean spirit, convulsing him and crying out with a loud voice, came out of him. They were all amazed, and they kept on asking one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even the unclean spirits, and they obey him." At once, his fame began to spread throughout the surrounding region of Galilee. Even the evil and unclean spirits of this world know who Jesus is. They know God, and they know God's power to rebuke all evil in this world. This term, rebuke, it is an expression of the authority of Jesus. It's a term of reprimand and warning. It lets people know that something is disapproved of and it needs to stop. Growing up, I'm sure that you and I have both had parents or guardians in our lives reprimand, rebuke us for something that you know, that I know we shouldn't have been doing. They basically said to us, "This needs to stop." That's what's happening in this passage today. There is an evil work at play, and it has entered into the house of God. And it's disapproved of by Jesus. And Jesus, like a good guardian, like a good parent, says that it needs to stop. We need to be mindful that Jesus' teaching on this day is not happening just anywhere. The text says that Jesus' teaching, it's happening in the synagogue, the place where people of the Jewish faith gather to worship and to pray and to learn and to give praise to God. This is the setting where the evil spirit enters. I consider it to be an important note because I have come to realize that the evil spirits of this world try hard to get at people who enter into places and communities of worship. You see, places and communities of worship are often known as places where people can come and gather together in safety, solidarity, fellowship, and love. And yet, the evil powers present in this world seek nothing more than to bring destruction, division, and hatred to these spaces. Just go ahead and raise your hand with me today if you have ever seen destruction, division, and hatred ever enter spaces like this, ever enter places of worship, ever enter communities of solidarity and love. These things are pervasive. They're all over. This story from Mark's gospel, it presents to us the realization of a mighty clash at work in this world, between good and between evil. And so in response to this realization, I have some suggestions for you and for me today. First, you and I must acknowledge that there is evil present within this world. As I said a minute ago, it's pervasive, and that means it's all around. It's all over. It even seeps into our sacred spaces, our institutions, and our community centers. To define it further, evil is a force outside of God. It is outside of God. I need to be clear about that, but it acts out. It acts out to upend and to destroy all of God's good creation in this world. God has power, but evil has power too. And it gets inside of the hateful and the destructive things and actions that human beings do. I don't like it. Neither do you. In this story today, It proves to you and to me that God does not desire to just sit idly by and just let evil go on about doing its thing in this world without consequences. And so in Mark chapter 1, Jesus enters the scene as the personification of God's response to the evil in this world. I'm so glad that Jesus enters the scene as the personification of God's response to the evil in this world. The Gospel of Mark declares to us today that Jesus rebukes all evil. And hear me now. Jesus doesn't go about rebuking evil behind the scenes or behind closed doors. Jesus works, and Jesus is working to rebuke all evil out in the public domain, out in places and spaces and circles where things need to be named as evil before God and before people. This story today, it is a record of Jesus' first public confrontation and defeat of evil in a place of worship. There, standing directly before Jesus in the synagogue that day, was a man with an unclean spirit acting out inside of him and through him. This example in Mark 1 was clearly the work of evil. Evil was at work within this man's life, within the synagogue. And sometimes evil gets a hold of us, all of us, in the church, outside of the church, in the synagogue, outside the synagogue. It gets a hold of all of us at times. And it would try and work in us and try and work through us to have us do things that are harmful and that we have no business doing. And so the guardian, the creator of this world and its people, is responding to that evil and expressing disapproval of it. God in Jesus Christ is saying, this needs to stop. In Mark's gospel, evil also spoke directly to good. Right in verse 24, we can see that evil said to good, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." I had some fun with this one because I started envisioning, okay, what if I were to put Jesus in the South in response to what the evil spirit said to Jesus that day? And I believe Jesus would have responded something like, "I ain't got nothing to do with you. I ain't got nothing to do with you. And yes, I have come to destroy you." That is a word today. That is a word today. Jesus has nothing to do with evil, and Jesus has come to destroy it. Evil can sure enough identify with good and seek to destroy the good in this world. And I'm here to tell you today that we need to be able to recognize and to name the evil present in this world. That was my first suggestion, that we need to be able to acknowledge and to recognize and to name it. Jesus didn't want to hear any more from the evil in the synagogue that day. Jesus knew and Jesus knows that evil needs to stop. And so Jesus rebuked that evil right there on the spot. In verse 25, Jesus said, "Be silent. Be silent. And come out of him." And it did. The evil was silenced before God and before people with the actions of Jesus. Oh, I yearn for those words to be said again and again and again and again by Jesus today. Be silent and come out of them. That Jesus would look at us and look at people and look at the evil of this world and say, "Be silent." And come out of these spaces and these places and these people whom I love so dearly. Because Jesus identifies evil, rebukes it, and silences it. Jesus utterly destroys it, and that is the power of God at work in this world. That is the power of Jesus Christ. That's who I'm preaching about today. That is the message and the miracle of this day. The Creator, the Guardian, the Savior of this world has come in the flesh to identify and rebuke and dismantle and destroy all of the evil present in this world. All of the evil that seeks to undo and to disintegrate all of God's good creation. You've heard me say this before, and I say it a lot, but my mama would always tell me, God don't like ugly. God don't like ugly. And evil. Evil is ugly. God don't like it. Evil presently exists in things that are on the forefront of my mind today. Things such as perpetuated racism and white supremacy and oppression and violence and injustice, these things, each of them, serve to dehumanize other people and to render some people as better than other people. And it just ain't right, and it needs to stop. These things are harmful. They do not represent Jesus, and we have no business participating in them or perpetuating them. You see, in Mark's gospel, the people of that time, they took note of how Jesus responded to evil. They realized, as the text makes clear, that Jesus has authority. This Jesus can command evil to cease. And I want to be a part of what Jesus is doing. And not only that, but I need to go out and tell other people and share with other people about this great work of Jesus in this world. This response to Jesus in Mark chapter 1, you can see it right at the end of the verses I read aloud. This response is my charge and your charge today. That our living and our doing and our seeing and our sharing would inform other people that evil is not something we will endorse or participate in. That we would make a conscious choice to a movement to do no harm in our lives. That with Jesus' power working in us and working through us, working in you and working through you, my hope is that we together can name and identify all of the evil present around us. That we can name it and that we can repent of it. That's my hope and prayer, that we can repent of it, that we can turn fully away from it, that we can recognize it, and we can decide we want to turn away from it. That if we have been participating in or perpetuating it, that we would repent of it, which means to turn away. What I'm saying today is that it is okay. It is okay, and in fact, a good thing, to name the sin and the sorrow and the evil that has been present in us and around us. It is a good thing to be able to name it and to acknowledge it, but then we can't stop there. We shouldn't stop there. I don't want us to stop there. Like the people present on the scene in Mark's gospel long ago, we can also make a commitment to then turning our lives and our attention directly to the authority of Jesus to rebuke and destroy all evil. If we are going to participate in anything, let us participate like they did here in the growing name and fame of Jesus Christ. Let us participate in what Jesus is doing in this world to dismantle all evil. Let us participate in this work in the church and in the community, in our workplaces, in our safe places, in our households, in our families, in all places that we know to be out and around us and within us. Let us participate in bringing glory to the name of Jesus. And letting that name and witness guide how we love and we behave in each and every one of our days on this earth. That is my dream, that is my hope, that is my prayer. And I would hope and I would pray and I would dream that we can join in this work together. Because it is a good work and it is a faithful work and it is a work rooted in Jesus. Can we do that? Can we participate in this work together? That's my hope. I think about it all the time. And I want it to be something that we can all put our minds and our energy and our attention to doing together, because it shouldn't just be for you and it shouldn't just be for me. It should be a communal work. Of people of all nations and races and backgrounds and creeds coming together and saying, this is evil and this needs to stop. So let us acknowledge clearly and firmly today, in word and in deed, that we disapprove of evil in all its forms and that it needs to stop. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Dear Hay, I saw you on the news today, like a shark that takes my breath away. You fall like rain, cover us in drops of pain. I'm afraid that there we just might drown. Dear hate, well, you sure are colorblind. Your kiss is the cruelest kind. You can poison any mind. Just look at mine. Don't know how this world keeps spinning round and round. You were there in the garden, like a snake in the grass. I see you in the morning, staring through the looking glass. You whisper down through history and echo.
He cried, he pulled those towers from the sky. But even on our darkest night, the world keeps spinning round.
You were there in the garden, like a snake in the grass. I see you in the morning, staring through the looking glass. You whisper down through history and echo. You were there in the garden when I ran. hear you every morning through the chaos and the noise. You still whisper down through history and echo through these halls and tell me love's gonna conquer all. It's gonna conquer.
This work of dismantling evil in our world, it is a team effort. Jesus leads the team, but you and I are invited each and every day to play key roles on it. And so be empowered today, give thanks, and know that love wins. In Jesus' name, amen.
Gonna conquer.